Speak of the devil. You see, Brock, I always said I could beat any person on this planet. Any man on this planet. But I'm not so sure I could have beaten the Big Show on my own, especially with Paul Heyman in his corner, if it wasn't for you. Now, I know you don't want to thank you. I know you don't want a pat on the back. I know, Brock. You want something different. You want what every person in this arena wants. You want what every person in this world wants to see. The most anticipated match in WWE history. Kurt Angle versus Brock Lesnar.
Oh, yeah.
No doubt, no doubt. That will be off the hook.
One-on-one for the WWE Championship. Am I right? Well, Brock, I'm a man of my word. And I said, if I won this title, you'd be the first one to get the title shot. So here it goes, Brock. NCAA champion versus Olympic gold medalist. The match that everyone wants to see, the most anticipated match in the world. Brock, you earned it. Anytime, anywhere, any place. You name it.
I'm glad you feel that way, Kurt, because I want that match here tonight in Tampa.
That sounds incredible, Brock. That sounds good to me. But it's not gonna happen.
What?
You see, Brock, I'm a little banged up as it is, but more importantly, I already have a match scheduled with Chris Benoit, a non-title match, because I promised you the first title match. And Brock, it's already been signed. My hands are tied. My hands are tied. But listen to me. Listen to me. No one in this company, no one on this planet can understand the sacrifice and dedication it takes to be the best in the world more than me. So if it's a title shot you want, Brock, it's a title shot you got. The match everyone wants to see, Kurt Angle versus Brock Lesnar. Next week on SmackDown, what do you say?
The fans in Tampa don't like it, but they'll be happy in Tulsa.
Brock, I said you'll get your first, Brock, you get the first title shot. It'll be next week on SmackDown. What do you say, Brock? You earned it.
WWE Championship. You heard what that little twerp said. Kurt admitted he couldn't beat me without Brock Lesnar's help. And now Brock Lesnar gets the first shot at the WWE Championship. I don't have to face Brock Lesnar to get my WWE title back. I want Kurt Angle. And you, as my agent, better make sure that I get the first shot at Kurt Angle.
Show, I have a way that guarantees that you're going to be the first challenger to Kurt Angle's title.
Broken promises, Paul. Broken promises.
Show, you know me. It's why you hired me. I always have a contingency plan. And this time, going into Armageddon, I had the greatest contingency plan of them all.
Well, Mr. Agent, your little contingency plan better guarantee that I get the first shot at the WWE Championship.
Okay.
Fast.
Okay.
Wow. That was a little slowed up there.
Brock, tonight is your lucky night. Because on my way to the ring, I lodged something in my good eye, and now I don't have any vision at all.
That's not good.
So needless to say, Matt Hardy version 1 won't be able to compete tonight. But in a very fortunate twist of fate, I have found a suitable replacement. The original Mattitude follower, Shannon Moore.
That's nice.
Well, that's not good if you're Shannon.
I don't think Shannon knew anything about it.
That's like a guppy getting close to the great white.
Ladies and gentlemen. Shannon Moore just said, "Whoa! What are you doing?"
Like a rag doll.
I would be able to.
Come on.
I think Matt Hardy pulled up a big yellow there, wouldn't you say?
Uh-oh. Oh my God.
Oh, no!
Shit.
Wow. We got to take another look at the power of Brock Lesnar.
This had to be at least 10 or 12 feet away from the ring. F5. Here comes the pain. Goodbye.
Oh, Shannon Moore. Double F5 to Shannon Moore.
Sacrificial land.
Here's the cover, and Brock Lesnar makes quick work of Shannon Moore.
Here's your winner, Brock.
You think Lesnar's focused for Kurt Angle, Cole?
Yeah, I think he is. Next week, Angle and Lesnar for the WWE title right here on SmackDown.
I cannot believe that belly to belly suplex over the top rope. I cannot believe that F5, the velocity of spin.
I can't believe Matt Hardy threw his buddy, supposedly. We're getting more to the wolves.
Lesnar is focused, man. He is pumped, primed, and ready to go for Angle next week on SmackDown, the WWE Championship.
Well, that's going to be one hell of a matchup. The two great amateur teams. Hey.
Turn around,
wait a minute.
Oh, boy.
Matt Hardy, black eye and all.
Brock Lesnar, man, this is his world, and all these squirrels are just trying to find a nut.
What is that, a Mattitude Massacre?
Well, I don't know if Matt Hardy would like hearing that. I don't know if Matt Hardy can hear anything right now. Shannon Moore, probably thinks.
I mean, be honest with yourself, ladies and gentlemen. Don't you now realize that since a week before Armageddon, when Kurt Angle and I conceived of this whole plan, that we were in it all along together? Think about this, Kurt. It all started when you went to Brock Lesnar and said, "Brock, please be in my corner at Armageddon." And then, of course, I got Stephanie McMahon so riled up that she lifted the suspension of Brock Lesnar. And my heart was pounding. My heart was pounding at the mere opportunity to screw Brock Lesnar all over again.
One more time.
And then, Kurt, at Armageddon, and this was all yours, at Armageddon, well, I went to Stephanie McMahon and said that if Brock Lesnar was in your corner against the Big Show, that the Big Show would break Brock's neck. And meanwhile, Kurt Angle, you went into Brock Lesnar's locker room and you played the tape of Survivor Series when I screwed Brock Lesnar out of the WWE title.
That was your idea.
Right to Brock Lesnar's face. You played Brock Lesnar. You manipulated Brock Lesnar. You played him like a violin. And here's the best part now. As my first act as Kurt Angle's agent, I want to publicly declare that the Kurt Angle Brock Lesnar match for the WWE title is hereby postponed indefinitely.
Damn! Come on, Paul!
Because my client wants to pursue other options. My client wants to pursue other challengers. Any challenger but Brock Lesnar.
I cannot believe this.
Hey, Brock! From me and the champ to you, getcha again!
We got it!
Well,
show him!
You little rat! You little rat!
Oh, God.
You represented me. You represented Kurt Angle. At the same time, at Armageddon. What in the hell is wrong with you?
Look at Kurt.
Now listen to reason, Big Show. Listen to reason. I told you I had the greatest contingency plan of all time. And I want you to think about this. I dumped Brock Lesnar for you. I'm not dumping you for Kurt Angle. You're still my favorite client, and Kurt Angle knows it. This is the greatest thing that's ever happened. Think about this. Think of the leverage that we now have together. We have a 7-foot-tall, 500-pound giant that put The Undertaker on the disabled list. The man that handed Brock Lesnar his first defeat ever. And we have an Olympic gold medalist who's a WWE champion. Think about the power that we now have. Think about the leverage that we now have. Think about the bargaining position that we now have. And show, with the three of us all together, I have so much leverage that I'm gonna walk right back there right now to Stephanie McMahon's office. And as the agent of the Big Show and Kurt Angle, I am going to demand that since Kurt Angle will not be facing Brock Lesnar next week, that Kurt Angle defends the WWE title next week right here on SmackDown against you!
What are you doing? Well, that's a win-win for Heyman.
That's a good idea. Listen, Kurt, as long as you're the champion, or as long as the Big Show is the champion, then we're the ones in power. As long as that title never again belongs to Brock Lesnar.
It never ends. With Heyman, the misery never ends.
Michael and Taz, think about the state of mind that Brock Lesnar must be in right now. Brock Lesnar was the victim of an elaborate plan. Brock Lesnar is responsible for Kurt Angle being the new WWE champion, and Brock was manipulated into doing so by Kurt Angle and Kurt's new business agent, Brock's former agent, Paul Heyman. We'll get comments from Brock Lesnar when we come back.
And there is the rabid Wolverine, Chris Benoit. A huge match, non-title tonight against Kurt Angle.
Earlier tonight, it was revealed that Paul Heyman is Kurt Angle's new business agent. However, prior to that revelation, Brock Lesnar and Kurt Angle were in the middle of the ring, eye to eye, when Kurt shook Brock's hand and promised him the number one shot at the WWE Championship. Well, quite frankly, Kurt was lying through his teeth, and I can't imagine this, your state of mind.
State of mind? You want to know my state of mind?
That's a good question.
The crossface is locked in!
Angle's out! Benoit gonna get Angle to tap!
Well, look at Paul Heyman, he cannot believe it. Will Kurt Angle tap to the crossface of Chris Benoit?
Come on, Benoit! What you doing?
The hell is this? It's the Big Show!
Russo!
The Big Show with a shot slam! Angle will hang! It's Brock Lesnar!
Oh my God!
Heyman's henchmen paying immediate dividends.
Brock trying to fight back. Two on one.
The double team. An Angle slam to Brock Lesnar. The Big Show's not done yet.
Big choke slam.
Oh!
WWE Championship, a match between Kurt Angle and the Big Show tonight. Unfortunately, that match is not going to take place. And it's all due to Brock Lesnar. See, what you all don't know is what Brock Lesnar did to Kurt Angle after SmackDown went off the air last week. Kurt Angle will not be able to compete tonight. As a matter of fact, Kurt Angle might not even be able to compete until the Royal Rumble. But I'm not gonna sit here and explain to you all what happened to Kurt Angle. I'm gonna show you the footage later tonight. Now, as far... Well, thanks for interrupting me, show. But where's your mouthpiece? Where's your agent, Paul Heyman?
Stephanie, Paul's not here yet. And I wanted to speak to you myself.
So you came out here and interrupted me? You couldn't wait and speak to me in my office like everybody else?
You know, Steph, I didn't feel like waiting. I just heard that Kurt Angle might not be able to defend his WWE Championship until Royal Rumble. And I didn't hear you name me as Kurt Angle's opponent. Now I'm sure that was just an oversight, right?
I'm sure you meant to make that match, right, Stephanie?
Show everything I do for a reason. And unless you want to wind up suspended like Brock Lesnar was, then I suggest you back off!
Wow!
Gutsy Broad.
Now, Paul Heyman did name you as the number one contender to face Kurt Angle last week. But I am the general manager of SmackDown, not Paul Heyman. And I think you need to earn your title shot. Therefore, tonight, you will compete in a number one contenders match, the winner of which to face Kurt Angle at Royal Rumble. So tonight's match, Big Show, will be you versus Chris Benoit.
Tonight!
That's big, and I think that's fair.
Chris Benoit, that little toothless wonder can't hold a candle to me. I'm 7 foot tall. I'm 500 pounds.
You have absolutely no idea what I am capable of, Big Show. And don't even think for a second that I forgot about you chokeslamming me last week. You know, the only thing stopping me from breaking your damn neck right now is our match tonight. Last week, I made Kurt Angle tap. Just like I'm gonna make you tap tonight. And go on to be the number one contender for the WWE title.
Listen, Benoit, I'm a giant. And obviously, you're not. And the only chance in hell you have of beating me is to take me from my size all the way down to your size. And I don't see that happening.
And look at the grimace and pain on the Big Show face.
That was like a gunshot from Chris Benoit. The Robin Wolverine with a first strike here tonight, sending the Big Show a little message for later on. Lesnar and Kurt Angle. This is the celebration, Taz, as SmackDown went off the air. Brock Lesnar left lane in the middle of the ring by the Big Show and Kurt Angle.
You go out there, big man, and you do it. You win that match tonight. Because nobody deserves a title shot more than you. Not Benoit. Benoit's never been a champion before. You have. And it would be my honor to face a real champion. A real athlete. A real giant like you at the Royal Rumble. Now, sure, I'd go out there with you. But I can't help you physically. But I'll tell you this, I'll be there with you tonight in spirit. Now you go do it. You got it. Thank you.
The Big Show meets Chris Benoit to determine the number one contender next.
Do it.
Oh, and a shot to the side of the head again. This matchup to determine the number one contender to meet Kurt Angle at the Royal Rumble for the WWE
Uh-oh.
Title.
This is a mistake.
Oh my God, there is no way.
Do it!
A German suplex, 500 pounds of the Big Show driven to the mat.
Well, let's face it, I think a lot of the Big Show's body landed on Chris Benoit's chest. The German's a risky move. But Benoit's saying the end is near.
Paul Heyman can't believe it.
But the Big Show's so damn big, he couldn't hit it.
I know, it was like a splash by Benoit. Big Show's body takes up half the ring.
It's unreal. I still can't believe it.
I can't believe it because that's Chris Benoit. But what has Chris Benoit got left? What's he got left after trying to hit that German on a 500-pound monster?
Here's Big Show. And oh, Benoit goes right to the knees. The exposed turnbuckle lands flat straight into the head of Big Show.
Yeah, right to that massive skull-like head. That big typewriter head of the Big Show. And here comes Benoit. Uh-oh.
Oh, look out. Big Show with that big hand around the neck of Benoit. Benoit countered. He's in the throat. Hooks the line. Benoit wins. Benoit wins. Benoit's the number one contender.
The winner of this match and number one contender for the WWE Championship, Chris Benoit.
Chris Benoit meets Kurt Angle at the Rumble.
Chris Benoit. Show with a Peterson roll with a little help from the bottom rope. It's all good.
But Big Show is furious and he's stalking Benoit.
He beat the Big Mats with a wrestling hold, but this is dangerous for Benoit.
Oh no. Oh no.
Got
hey, look at him. A counter. The cross face.
He's got him. Cross face. Look at Big Show's tapping. He's tapping. Don't matter though.
The Big Show tapping to the cross face.
Sustained a broken neck months and months ago.
Where the hell is Shelton Benjamin going?
Powerbomb into a bulldog by Team Angle.
These men are tremendous athletes and they're using their skills for malicious intent. The hell is this?
The nasty submission. Submission by Haas. Shelton Benjamin putting the boots. Benoit tapping. And Paul Heyman playing the role he knows so well of a ringleader.
Oh no.
The end is near for the Rabid Wolverine, ladies and gentlemen. Choke slam coming. All the way up in the air, 10 feet or so.
A choke slam to a defenseless Chris Benoit.
Now, I also know how much you're all looking forward to seeing Brock Lesnar in action tonight. But the reason why this entire arena is sold out, and the reason why these people paid to come here tonight, is because of my favorite client, a man who stands head and shoulders above all competition. Ladies and gentlemen, 7 feet tall, 500 pounds, The Big Show.
Well,
you got it?
I gotta let you know, I feel empowered just standing next to you. I mean, just standing here with you makes me feel like such a man. You are 7 feet tall. You are 500 pounds. There are no athletes that compare to your dimensions. And you are a competitor that never backs down from a challenge. Which is why, sir, if you don't mind, allow me to announce publicly that my client and I would like to announce we have a challenge for Brock Lesnar.
Hell.
You see, on Sunday night, January 19th, there is an event called the Royal Rumble. And more so than just the event called the Royal Rumble is the match called the Royal Rumble. And this year will be the greatest Royal Rumble of them all because there will be 15 superstars from SmackDown in the very same ring at the very same time with 15 superstars from Raw. Now, what that means is that both Raw and SmackDown superstars can and will fight it out at the very same time, but it also means something so much more because it's every single man for himself. And the winner of the Royal Rumble event gets through 29 other men and goes on for the opportunity of a lifetime, and that opportunity, Big Show, is the chance to fight, the chance to wrestle his respective brand's champion at the 19th annual WrestleMania. Now, you may be pumped about it, but I have a problem with that. Because that means that Brock Lesnar may get through 29 other people and get a shot at the title at WrestleMania. And it's my life's ambition that Brock Lesnar never gets near the WWE title again. So Brock, I say, we raise the stakes at the Royal Rumble. We all know that it's the Big Show that took the WWE title away from Brock Lesnar. We all know that the Big Show is the only man to score a 1-2-3 over Brock Lesnar. That the Big Show is the only man with a pinfall victory over Brock Lesnar. Well, Brock, here's your chance at revenge against the Big Show. I say at the Royal Rumble, it's Brock Lesnar one-on-one against the Big Show.
Wow.
That's big.
But I say it's for so much more because I say that it's winner take all, that the loser of the match falls to the wayside, and only the winner of the match gets into the Rumble itself. And that winner gets to face 29 other competitors from both Raw and SmackDown for the mere opportunity of a shot at either brand's title at WrestleMania. It makes so much sense to me.
It does.
could have brought earlier.
Which is why Brock Lesnar will never accept. Because you see, ladies and gentlemen, in all honesty, Brock Lesnar fears the Big Show. Brock Lesnar is afraid of the Big Show. Brock Lesnar trembles and has nightmares about my giant client. Because Brock, I told you this before I screwed you at Survivor Series, and I'll tell you this again, Brock, you can't beat the Big Show. You can't beat the Big Show. Brock Lesnar, you can't beat the Big Show. You could.
Uh-oh, it's Brock Lesnar.
Yeah, he don't look too scared either.
He doesn't look like he's trembling. Slowly making his way to the ring with his eyes.
Be careful what you ask for, Heyman.
Lesnar methodically making his way to the ring.
Smart.
You come get something, I will bust you out. That just brought by surprise. What a shot by Hardy and Shannon Moore.
I can't believe Shannon Moore's here. That's another story. Brock Lesnar with shots to the Big Show.
Oh, man.
And now a clothesline.
For the back.
Big Show knocked over the top rope.
Look at the head. Look at the head of Brock Lesnar's busted open.
The ambush did the damage by Matt Hardy and Shannon Moore. More of Brock Lesnar.
Oh, my God.
He meets Matt Hardy tonight.
Yeah, Lesnar just seen the blood on his hand. Shannon Moore both can't beat Brock Lesnar.
Went for another twist of fate. Brock Lesnar with a counter.
Goodbye. Some pain in the house.
The F5 delivered.
Goodbye.
Oh, look at the leg. Brock Lesnar wins.
Here is your winner, Brock Lesnar.
I was trying to say Cole was like a handicap match, and Hardy and Shannon Moore was a handicap.
Brock Lesnar promised mayhem. Brock Lesnar delivered mayhem.
Brock Lesnar bloodied and battered. Not battered, just bloodied. But that F5 will put your lights out in a heartbeat. Brock Lesnar, I think, likes the taste of his own blood in his mouth.
Paul Heyman promised that Brock Lesnar would never get a title shot again. Brock Lesnar has an opportunity. But first, he must beat the Big Show in a match at the Royal Rumble just to get in to the Royal Rumble match in 2.5 weeks. And there is Paul Heyman in the Big Show. Which of these men will prevail at the Royal Rumble?
Yeah, which one of these two men will participate on the SmackDown brand in that Royal Rumble? But Lesnar, Big Show, Heyman grinning.
Will it be Big Show or Brock Lesnar who will advance to meet 29 other men at the Royal Rumble match?
Uh-oh. Oh, Brock's not done. Sending a message to the Big Show. Trying to beat the Big Show in the ring.
Lesnar making an example of Matt Hardy.
Yeah, Matt Hardy's a sacrificial lamb.
Oh, no.
You gotta feel it, man. It's another F5. Another F5. It's gonna be a big one. I bet it. I guarantee it. This goes to the Big Show.
That is dedicated to the Big Show. Who is going to win to get to the Royal Rumble match? Brock Lesnar for the Big Show. Thank you, everybody. Good night from Albuquerque.
And what about the pressure a 500-pounder can put on Rikishi with this move?
Well, the Big Show's using his weight, his height advantage as leverage with this abdominal stretch, extremely painful maneuver.
We mentioned Brock Lesnar, Big Show's opponent at the Royal Rumble, will be in action later on tonight against the A-Train. What about Brock Lesnar last week competing against Matt Hardy after that chair shot to the head?
The setup.
18 stitches from Brock Lesnar and a concussion suffered after that chair shot.
Well, Brock Lesnar ain't no crybaby, and I feel it. He was obviously got set up by Heyman and the Big Show, and Matt Hardy, you know, big part of that setup.
Yeah, despite the concussion and the stitches, Brock Lesnar beat the holy hell out of Matt Hardy.
Sure did. And right now, it might be a different story tonight. The A-Train's in there going against Lesnar. But right now, that abdominal stress just wearing out Rikishi.
SmackDown fans chanting for Rikishi, trying to will the 350-pounder out of this abdominal stretch.
The two sides behind the big Kish.
Works. Oh, and a shot to the ribs. Clubbing blow.
Big Show stretched out the ribs in the abdominal area and then clubbing with that big monstrous forearm.
You believe the winner of the Brock Lesnar Big Show matchup as Rikishi battles back will be the favorite going into the Royal Rumble match itself?
No, I don't think so, Cole. I mean, you're going through a match, both Lesnar and Big Show, the size of these guys, then you got to go and face another 29 guys in a Rumble. I don't think it'd be a favorite.
Good point, partner. Oh, look at Rikishi. Oh, what a clothesline! Rikishi spinning like a top.
Rikishi getting turned inside out.
You've known the Big Show for a long time. Have you ever seen him as intense as he's been here in the past few weeks, tonight?
That man right there, Paul Heyman, he gets people focused. He gets his men focused, and that's why the Big Show, he's got that look in his eye, and there's a goozle on Rikishi.
Big Show taking his time. A choke slam to Rikishi, planted. The Big Show, an impressive victory.
The Big Show with one hand lifting up a 350-pound athlete in the air. That was impressive, an impressive victory by the Big Show.
Before this evening is over with, we are going to teach a lesson to Brock Lesnar.
What is that all about?
Okay, Brock Lesnar is next. And we're gonna teach him a lesson.
A-Train. Rumor has it you two plan on teaching Brock Lesnar a lesson tonight.
Yep.
Let me make myself perfectly clear, crystal clear. You two can have whatever's left of Brock Lesnar when I'm finished with him tonight.
Okay.
You see, I plan on solidifying my reputation tonight by busting up Brock Lesnar, just like I did to Rey Mysterio. See, I inflicted a career-threatening injury to Rey Mysterio. And tonight, the same shall happen to Brock Lesnar. Because Rey Mysterio doesn't measure up to A-Train physically. Brock Lesnar doesn't measure up to A-Train physically. As a matter of fact, no one around here measures up to A-Train physically.
A-Train!
You know, part of what makes a guy a killer in that ring is confidence. And A-Train shows, look at this.
The two men who promised to teach Brock Lesnar a lesson here tonight. Well, Al Heyman and Big Show settling in.
My point was that A-Train showed a lot of confidence before the commercial break. But he told Heyman and Big Show, no one can match up to him physically.
Maybe right.
Well, here comes the pain.
And from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 295 pounds, Brock Lesnar.
This will be a true test for Brock Lesnar tonight. But here is a man who last week, after being hit in the head with a steel chair by Matt Hardy,
concussion,
refused medical attention, went out into the ring and destroyed Matt Hardy and Shannon Moore. He needed 18 stitches to close a gash in the back of his head, and Lesnar's here tonight with a concussion, ready to take on the A-Train.
That just shows how determined Brock Lesnar is to defeat the Big Show at the Royal Rumble and get in the Royal Rumble matchup. to get a shot back at WrestleMania, if he can, at the WWE Championship.
But as I mentioned, this is a true test for Brock Lesnar. Look how much bigger the A-Train is. He outweighs Brock Lesnar by almost 60 pounds.
Well, collar and elbow tie-up right here. Two big monsters. Ain't no one giving an inch either. Stay corrected. Brock's just feeling out A-Train, I'm thinking. These two men never met before.
See Brock Lesnar going to the back of his head. That's where he suffered the concussion and the cut last week. And Brock Lesnar driving A-Train into the corner, in the shoulders, into the guts of the big man.
That's the speed of Lesnar, sucked in that high double leg.
And now the shots to the gut as well, as Brock Lesnar whips A-Train across the ring with authority and an elbow to the face, and Lesnar still on his feet. Uh-oh, look out. Choke.
Wow! I am impressed.
Here's the cover.
He's got it!
And Lesnar just got the shoulder up. Cover again. And again, Brock Lesnar gets the shoulder up.
Relentless physicality by the A-Train. That's what you need to do when you're in the ring with Brock Lesnar.
You know, Paul Heyman's got to be sitting in the locker room with Big Show, liking what he sees here. As the A-Train looks to hurt, looks to soften up Brock Lesnar before the Rumble. Brock Lesnar meets the Big Show at the Rumble with so much at stake, Taz. The winner gets entered into the Royal Rumble matchup. The loser, well, he doesn't have a shot. And for Brock Lesnar, the Royal Rumble matchup.
Wow! God, talk about a high knee.
For Brock Lesnar, the Royal Rumble match could be Brock Lesnar's only shot he has left of getting a WWE title shot. Paul Heyman, who represents the current champion, Kurt Angle, says Lesnar will never get a shot against his client. And look at A-Train manhandling Lesnar.
Hot shot like maneuver.
There's the quickness of Brock Lesnar and the strength as well as he plants the A-Train.
Well, Heyman feels he holds all the cards. But he doesn't now. I mean, actually he does, being that he represents Kurt Angle. Kurt Angle's one of Heyman's clients. Brock Lesnar has to earn a championship shot.
Oh!
But he's got to beat the Big Show first.
Well, Paul Heyman also represents the Big Show. Oh. If Paul Heyman could ensure a Kurt Angle Big Show match.
Look at this!
Wow!
350 pounds, belly-to-belly suplex by Lesnar.
And again, 350 pounds tossed halfway across.
We've seen Lesnar, look at the intensity, the gaze. We've seen Lesnar suplex the Big Show.
And he suplexed A-Train a third time.
Big Show 500 bills, 500 pounds.
Each and every week, I become more and more impressed with Brock Lesnar. And a headbutt by A-Train.
That's a lot of head, too.
And another one. A-Train using everything he can to battle out.
Remember that concussion.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, F5 in the house. This might be the end, Paul.
F5 to the 350-pound A-Train. The cover hooks the leg. It's over.
Here is your winner, Brock Lesnar.
Can Brock Lesnar do that to the Big Show in 10 days at the Royal Rumble?
Well, we know that Brock Lesnar can physically F5 the Big Show. Brock Lesnar has done it before, but can he beat the Big Show? Lesnar's never defeated the Big Show.
That is a great question. Will Brock Lesnar finally beat the Big Show at the Rumble?
Big Show! Paul Heyman! It looks like it's time for my lesson. So get your asses out here. We're going to school.
School's in
session. Come on!
Is that what he wants?
Let's give it to him.
Let's give it to him.
Let's give him the lesson.
Time for Brock Lesnar.
Let's go. Come on!
A lesson.
Brock Lesnar has called out the Big Show, and Big Show's on his way.
He wants you. Oh, he wants you, Big Show. Huh? He wants to learn a lesson. He doesn't think you're man enough to teach him a lesson. So are you man enough to teach him?
Yeah!
Huh? How much of a lesson are you going to teach Brock Lesnar tonight? Huh? How good of a lesson are you going to teach Brock Lesnar?
You hear Heyman, they promised to teach Lesnar a lesson here tonight.
Are we going to do this or not?
Oh, yeah. See, Brock, here's your lesson for the evening. You can't beat the Big Show. And with my strategy, you'll never get by the Big Show. Because just when you think we're going left, we go right.
What a slime bag.
Brock. Gotcha.
This Sunday, the road to WrestleMania begins at the Royal Rumble. Also this Sunday marks the return of one of the greatest superstars to ever compete in WWE history. SmackDown's own, the Phenom, The Undertaker. This Sunday, The Big Show will also face Brock Lesnar. Both men competing for a spot in the 30-man over-the-top rope Royal Rumble match. But both men, The Big Show and Brock Lesnar, want to get it on in the ring tonight in front of all of you. But I'm not going to give you that match. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to team The Big Show and A-Train to compete against Brock Lesnar and a partner to be named. Thank you.
Yes, I understand perfectly what you're saying. I just find it a little hard to believe that you didn't overhear anything. So fine, well, what about the 30-day deadline? Is Bischoff gonna get fired or what? Listen, Shane, you really need to level with me on this. But not right now. Yeah, I'll talk to you after the show. Bye.
You want to see me?
I did. I wanted to let you know who your tag partner is tonight.
I don't want or need a tag partner. If I go down to that ring tonight, and let's just say I do get my ass beat, I guarantee you one thing. Big Show and A-Train are going down with me.
Listen, Brock. I need to protect my investment in you. I want you to beat the Big Show this Sunday. I want you to win the Royal Rumble. I want to see you compete at WrestleMania. I mean, you're the biggest thing that's ever happened to SmackDown, which is why I'm not going to put you in a position to be outnumbered tonight.
Well, that's fine, Steph. If you feel the need to give me a tag partner, then you tell him one thing. I'll see him in the ring.
Interrupting while I was talking.
Heyman's got a mic.
There's a match
for what?
This Sunday at the Royal Rumble. It's a winner-take-all match. A match that both men have to win and neither man can afford to lose. And that match will pit my favorite client, the 7-foot-tall, 500-pound Big Show. Against Brock Lesnar. Now, the winner of this match, and only the winner of this match, moves on into the Rumble itself to face 29 other competitors from both Raw and SmackDown. And the winner of the Royal Rumble gets a title shot at WrestleMania. And by God, that will not be Brock Lesnar.
No way.
It won't be Brock Lesnar because I will never let Brock Lesnar even get near a title shot. How am I going to stop Brock Lesnar? Very simple. Three words. The Big Show. Because Brock, you can't beat the Big Show. You couldn't beat the Big Show at Survivor Series, and by God, you won't beat the Big Show this Sunday at the Royal Rumble, because the Big Show will beat Brock Lesnar. The Big Show will go into the Royal Rumble. And there the odds are stacked in our favor, because inside the Royal Rumble is my client, Charlie Haas. Inside the Royal Rumble is my client, Shelton Benjamin. Inside the Royal Rumble is our friend, the A-Train. So whether it's Charlie Haas, Shelton Benjamin, the A-Train, or the Big Show. The winner of the Royal Rumble will then go on to WrestleMania and get a WWE title shot against my client, Kurt Angle.
That's if Angle beats Benoit.
Well, here comes the pain.
From Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 295 pounds, Brock Lesnar.
I guess you're going to find out who Stephanie picked to be Lesnar's partner. Not that Lesnar gives a rat's ass about it.
Brock Lesnar doesn't want a tag team partner, but Stephanie doesn't want to jeopardize who she calls the best thing to happen to SmackDown.
Brock Lesnar. I agree with Stephanie. Brock Lesnar is a franchise player, the franchise player. Mysterio's got a score to settle with A-Train. A-Train's the man who put F5. F5's coming.
F5 to the 350-pound A-Train.
Uh-oh, Goozle by the big man. There goes Brock. Won't counter.
But Brock countered. Big Show knocked over the top.
Uh-oh.
Check it out.
619. Dial it up.
The 619 connects to A-Train.
A-Train.